And they gave it their all. We're in the woods of the river Loriva. This place here is one of the most incredible places I've ever been to. Here at the banks of the Blue Springs. Taking a fantastic scenery view. There's river rapids here still. The river is flowing after the rain. And this is one incredible day here. There's the pathway down to the river. I'd like to report March 2020, the month of the lockdown, worldwide pandemic, so-called invasion of 5G viral infusion into humankind, adaptation of the corporations, government, business, and religious. Meanwhile, here the sun is always shining and the river is always flowing. These rapids here just beautiful. Makes you want to sing for nature and all life, true reality life is. That is for sure. It's incredible. We're taking a walk down towards the river. Look at the color in the water. These trees along the coast. The rapids of this river. Months ago it was even lower and all those big rocks were all out in the open. There's a bend in the river here. Indians called it Withlacoochee. Going south. Stream, we're going towards Georgia. Going very rapidly, there was some recent rain, heavy, and it's brought the light, the sound, beauty. I love it. And my report today from the River Rapids, what we're doing to the natural environment, what we're doing to the human environment. This month, we spread a pandemic virus around the world. It's a flu, worse than the average flu. But it seems that the purpose is to imprison, control, and manipulate the populace into purchasing products, medicines, foods, and even faith in the governments and religions and businesses, for which they really deserve no values, except for what was already created by these humans, or what some believe, the reptilians and humalians, creating an alienated, isolated, locked up, bound up human captive audience to their media blitz, marketing ploy, creations. Meanwhile, this place knows no separate distinctions, needs no othernesses, has its own complete beingnesses, as we all do. You, I, and all are isness. This is one of the nicer isnesses that I've ever seen and know. Listen to that river flow. Take a little walk downhill. Beachside. There appears to be a spring. Pool, perhaps not a spring, but there's springs up and down this whole river. And there's a spring, most likely straight across over there. And if I go downstream here, there's another one right around this little bend, somewhere in there. Maybe even one right here in this little nook. I suppose if I wanted to speak about the crooks and those who have taken their own particular nook and made it the only one that you can listen to, people who have bought up all the land, stole it from the Indians originally, stole it from the natives, and sent the natives packing. This is very close to the Trail of Tears, and it's very close to where they have deposited the Indians who were in the left side, or this left side of the river up this way, and hiked them down, took their private property, and said, "Kaboots, you're booted across the river into the other counties that have been created since then." Of course, the Indians have been moved out of there as well. But the descendants still live here. And the rocks are still solid, and the trees are still beautiful, and the fish are still wonderful. Now, this river recently did get two sewage spills up in the Georgia side, which they've taken little or no responsibility for. And only after these good rains come and washes everything through and the river filters everything on its own, deep underneath the soil, there we get the healing and the purification. It's like standing here or being with this is for me. It seems to be this concerted effort, as strong as the flow of the river, purposeful, human population control experiment. People are not allowed to go to the national forest. At the moment, the entire state has a modality of visits only to necessities, that being stores, medicines, jobs, and meetings of groups of people, 10 or more, is prohibited. Everywhere people go, they're told to wear masks. And told to keep in their homes, and told to wash their hands and stay 6 to 10 feet away from each other. If they have a business that they want to run, at least half the businesses are shut down, and the only businesses open are those that are selling the foods produced by the large corporations. Beer, alcohols included. These things evidently are acceptable because they make their money selling them. Medicines as well. Foods, most likely produced GMO, processed, bagged, plasticized, chemicalized, using the fluoridated water. They have no mind about all of that. I'm perfectly happy that some of the population will be eliminated or inconvenienced. Many are not able to earn incomes and will not recover from this because they will still be processing debts, mortgages, bills, taxes, and all the rest of the control mechanism, economics. Still, when you're at a place like this, where the river is flowing like that, isn't that something? And just completely blown away by this particular place. And all these other things, some said stage of doesn't mean a thing. It's all nonsense. It's all gimme, take me, leave me. And just let it be and be on the real side in the true reality life is. And be with real nature here and now. Henry David Thoreau wrote about the pollution of man in Walden Pond. Rachel Carson wrote about the pollution of the chemical and business industries, agricultural, in Silver Spring. These classics, born on the rivers, and on the seas, and the skies, and the air, in the water, in the heart, everything that is real and true and good and beautiful. This river will wake you up, and this is a worldwide wake-up call. I hope you're all listening without needing to hope, because if you're not paying attention, you're not aware of the all is and the all that's here, there's a little more I could say, a little more we can do but swim downstream. Float up in the sky and say thank you for everything. This is Henry David Thoreau on the Real River. Thank you very much, y'all.